Okay, now there isn't a business or organization in the world that doesn't have to get involved in recruitment at some stage or another.
So let's get the inside track on how to find the right people.
You know, many companies turn to HR, the HR department, human resource industry, which is worth around $453 billion. That's worldwide. That's according to the World Employment Confederation.
Now, one reason it's growing is because of the apparent trend for people to change jobs more frequently. LinkedIn found US workers who graduated college between 2006 and 2010 averaged nearly 3 jobs in their first 5 years of work, compared to just over 1.5 jobs for those who graduated 20 years earlier.
Well, I didn't realize that. That's really interesting. And it does mean that companies have more time consuming reference checks to do so. And the Australian-based XRef says it has the answer with its cloud-based system. So, guess what we did? Come on.
I can see what's coming. Lee Martin Seymour, one of the men who came up with the idea, and his Express chief executive, joins us now in the studio. Lee Martin, thank you very much for coming in this morning.
Good morning.
So explain to us how your company works and how it is different to the traditional...
For the dummies, me.
The dummies. getting references.
Well, if you think about the traditional process of collecting references, it's done over the phone. It's an arduous process. Mm. Many recruiters and HR directors just don't like doing it. It takes days to collect feedback on potential candidates, and when we are short of skills, we need, you know, tools like XRef to be able to reduce that time to hire, help with things like attrition. So 6 years ago, myself and Tim Griffiths, the other co-founder, basically took the manual, arduous process that's existed for hundreds of years and decided to automate it in the cloud. What happens now is that the process is centered around the candidate. So instead of an employer making phone calls over days to try and collect this feedback, they simply go to XRef, they enter the candidate details in 15 seconds, and that's their job done until they collect the feedback back.
Okay.
The candidate adds the reference details into the application, and the referees then get an email to give that feedback back to the employer.
And just because we're constrained by time here, you took the company public in 2011 to expand and go overseas, and we'll talk about that, expand overseas. But the company, I'm assuming it's the companies that pay you the money. This is how you make money. But they've been doing this for hundreds of years. You said it yourself. Mm. So you've got to change that mentality for them to rely on this new technology.
Yeah, just to correct you there, Aaron, we listed at the start of 16. We had we started in 2011, we had 5 years, and 3 of those years were an education process, you know, pounding the pavement, hitting the phone, you know, trying to convince HR directors that the way that they were taking references in a traditional way just wasn't helping with privacy, discrimination, fraudulent references. And it took us 3 years to get to our first employee, and then another 2 to get to 5 employees. So it was a long mission to get to that point of going on to the ASX.
Now, currently you're based in Australia. You have office in London, office in Toronto.
Right.
You know, it all sounds like it's going well. You listed on the stock market was it 20 cents per share? You're now at 50 cents.
Yes.
So growth is going in the right direction, but it's not all been easy sailing, has it?
No, not at all. I think, you know, when you move from a local startup, despite all of the success we had in Australia, we knew that we had a replicable model. XRef offers its clients a huge return on investment. Our clients love using the product because it takes away the thing that they really don't like doing. But it knows no global bounds. So, you know, for us as a team, as a family at XRef, seeing that growth over time is fantastic. But I think it doesn't come without its challenges.
Mm.
And I think sometimes you have to make the hard decisions. And with listing on the ASX, we really needed a capital vehicle that would help us grow globally. We knew we had a global product on our hands, and you've really got to go all in. And as we know, reward is directly proportionate to the amount of risk that you're prepared to take. And I think, you know, the first 5 years we earned our stripes, and it was lovely to list as a product with revenue, with clients, with a successful part of the planet and then use that capital raise to progress globally.
Lee Martin Seymour, we appreciate it. If you can come up with a program that can give a 30-minute program, TV show, an extra 10 minutes, we'll buy that one.
No problem.
Okay, we appreciate it. Good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Okay.
Now here's how you can keep in touch with us.